वेलकम टू माय चैनल चैनल नंदु फिजिकल साइंस संबंधी लेसन्स विद एनिमेशन मरियु साइंस संबंधी एन्नो आसक्ति वीडियो लो नेनु फिजिकल साइंस नाइन्थ क्लास टेक्स्ट बुक लोनी फर्स्ट लेसन मोशन पार्ट टू नी चेप्पबोतुन्नानु। मोशन लेसन लोनी डिस्टेंस डिस्प्लेसमेंट गुरिंची पूर्ति विषयालनु मीकु एनिमेशन तो सहा विवरिस्तानु। ई वीडियोनी పూర్తిగా చివరి వరకు చూసి మీరందరూ కూడా విద్యార్థులందరూ కూడా నేర్చుకుంటారని ఆశిస్తున్నాను। దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ టాపిక్ ఇన్ అవర్ ఫిజికల్ సైన్స్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ డ్రాయింగ్ పాత్ టేక్ ఏ బాల్ ఏ బాల్ ఇస్ ఎట్ పాయింట్ ఏ త్రో ఇట్ ఇంటూ ద ఎయిర్ విత్ సమ్ యాంగిల్ టు ద హారిజాంటల్ యాంగిల్ హారిజాంటల్లో మనం ఒక యాంగిల్తో కనుక వేస్తే observe its path and draw it on paper. The path of the ball is like this. It travel through A, S, B. A is the initial point and B is the final point. This is the drawing path of a ball which is throw it into the air with some angle to the horizontal. Next, distance. Distance is the length of the path traversed by an object in a given time interval. And a distance ante oka object a path dwara travel avutundo a length of the path is called the distance. So ball is at the point A, throw it into the horizontal angle of horizontal and the path of the ball is like this. A, S, B is the distance. It travel through curve path. So, the total curve path is the distance of the ball. So, distance is equal to A, S, B. So, curve path kabatti dinni curve ga pettesam. Next, displacement. Displacement is the shortest distance covered by the object in a specified direction. Oka displacement ante shortest distance avali adi oka specified direction lo undali. So a ball is at point A, it throw some angle of horizontal, the path of the ball is like this. The displacement is from A to B, this is the straight line. AB line segment is equal to the displacement of the ball. This is the displacement and this is the curved path is the distance. Do you understand displacement and distance? Next, physical quantities. Physical quantities are two types. One is scalar quantities and another is vector quantities. Scalar quantities, the physical quantity which does not require any direction for its specification is called scalar. Oka physical quantity ni manam ye direction lekunda chepte ardham avutundo atvanti physical quantity ni scalar quantity antaru. For example, what is your length? What is the length of the book? You say the 10 centimeters, 15 centimeters. So it is a meaningful sentence. So the physical quantity only magnitude ne ganaka kan chepte dani scalar quantity antaru. The example, time, temperature, mass, length, area, volume, density, speed, work, power, energy, etc. These are the examples of scalar quantities. Next, second one, vector quantities. To describe a physical situation, some quantities are specified with magnitude as well as direction. Such physical quantity is called vector. Vector quantity ki manam em cheyalante daniki magnified cheppali, magnitude cheppali and also the direction kuda cheppali. So kabatti ee vector ane daniki magnitude untundi, direction untundi. Scalar quantity ki only magnitude matre untundi, direction there is no direction. So a vector can be represented as a directed line segment. Its length indicates magnitude and arrow indicates its direction. AB. This is the indication of vector quantity. Point A is called tail and point B is called head. Examples: displacement, velocity, acceleration, momentum, impulse, weight, force, etc. These are the examples of vector quantities. Do you understand vector quantities and scalar quantities? The main difference is the scalar has only magnitude and vector has both magnitude and direction. The units, the SI unit of distance or displacement is meter. It is denoted by m. 1 kilometer is equal 1000 meters and 1 meter is equal 100 centimeters. Next, draw the displacement vectors. A object is moved from A to B in this direction. So you draw the displacement vector. And displacement is the straight line path. So you draw from A to B in straight line way. This is the displacement vector. A is the initial position and B is the final position. And the next diagram, you see, in this diagram, you draw the displacement vector. You know the displacement vector. To draw displacement vector, you must draw straight line. So from A to B, you draw a straight line. This is the displacement vector for this diagram. Next, draw displacement vectors from Visakhapatnam to Vijayawada, Vijayawada to Hyderabad, and from Visakhapatnam to Hyderabad. This is the map. A vehicle travel from this place to this direction, this curved path in this is Vijayawada, and from Vijayawada to Hyderabad, a vehicle travel in this way. It reached Hyderabad. You draw first the question is, draw displacement vectors from Visakhapatnam to Vijayawada. This is the first. The Visakhapatnam and Vijayawada. You draw a displacement. To draw displacement vector, we must draw straight line from Visakhapatnam to Vijayawada. This is the displacement vector. And next question, Vijayawada to Hyderabad. So Vijayawada, this is Vijayawada, and this is Hyderabad. You draw a straight line. This is the from Vijayawada to Hyderabad displacement vector. And next, Visakhapatnam to Hyderabad. So here is Visakhapatnam and here is Hyderabad. You draw a straight line from Visakhapatnam to Hyderabad. This is the displacement vector. Okay, understood? Next question. Distinguish between distance and displacement. Distance and displacement. Can you say distance and displacement? What is the main difference between distance and displacement? Can you say? Oh, distance is scalar quantity and displacement is vector quantity. This is the main difference between distance and displacement. So you see, so distance, displacement, first you write the definitions of distance and displacement, and next another, the units, the distance and displacements have same units, meter. Distance is also meter, displacement is also, unit is meter. Just next point, distance is a scalar, displacement is a vector. So the main difference is distance is scalar and displacement is vector. Next, the most important point you should understood, distance will not be zero even if it reaches the initial position after its journey. అంటే ఏంటంటే ఒక వస్తువు ఇనీషియల్ పొజిషన్ నుంచి ట్రావెల్ చేసి మరలా ఇనీషియల్ పొజిషన్కే అంటే ఇనీషియల్ పొజిషను ఫైనల్ పొజిషను సేమ్ అయినప్పుడు కూడా డిస్టెన్స్ విల్ నాట్ బి జీరో. అర్థమైందా మీకు? నెక్స్ట్, డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ విల్ బికమ్ జీరో ఇఫ్ ఇట్ రీచెస్ ఇట్స్ ఇనీషియల్ పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఇట్స్ జర్నీ. అంటే ఇక్కడ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ అనేది జీరో అవుతుంది. ఎప్పుడు అవుతుందంటే ఇనీషియల్ పొజిషను ఫైనల్ పొజిషను ఒకే పాయింట్ అయినప్పుడు. ఈ రెండిటి యొక్క డిఫరెన్స్ని మీరు అండర్స్టాండ్ చేసుకోండి. సీ ద డయాగ్రామ్. ఏ బాల్ ఈజ్ మూవింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ పాయింట్ టు మళ్ళీ అండ్ ఇట్ రీచెస్ ద సేమ్ ఇనీషియల్ పొజిషన్. So, there is a distance will not be zero. The length of this curved path is the distance. And displacement, there a ball. Ball is moving circular. So, this is the initial point and moves from this way. Again, it reaches final position. This displacement is zero. Here is distance is will not be zero. Understood? Distance zero kaadu. Displacement zero avutundi. Eppudu zero avutundante displacement? Initial position is equal to the final position. Our two positions are same point. Next, think and discuss. This is most important questions in our test books. What is the displacement of the body if it returns to the same point from where it started? Give one example from daily life. Do you understand this question? What is the displacement of the body if it returns to the same point from where it started? Here asked a displacement. So, డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ అనగానే మీకు వెంటనే ఒక స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ అనేది గుర్తుకు రావాలి. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ ఆస్క్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ రిటర్న్స్ టు ద సేమ్ పాయింట్. ఏ పాయింట్ నుంచి అయితే స్టార్ట్ అయిందో నెక్స్ట్ అదే పాయింట్ కనుక రీచ్ అయితే వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్? హియర్ ఆస్క్డ్ అనుకుంటాను ఆన్సర్. సో ఒక్కసారి చెక్ చేసుకున్నారు కానీ మీ ఆన్సర్ని. సో ఆన్సర్, వెన్ ఏ బాడీ రిటర్న్స్ టు సేమ్ పాయింట్ where it is started, that is initial point position is equal to final position, then the displacement is zero. So give one example from daily life, ask the question. So the answer is, a student starts from his home, goes to a school and returns home, then his displacement is zero. Okay, understood the question? Next question. When do the distance and magnitude of displacement become equal? Again, I will read. When do the distance and magnitude of displacement become equal? The distance and magnitude of displacement become equal when the body moves along a straight line in one direction. The distance and magnitude of displacement become equal when the body moves along a straight line in one direction. Magnitude ante sorry distance displacement rendu equal avvalante aa body kachithanga straight line lo oke direction lo move avutu undali. So just see the picture. AB is the straight line, the way the ball is initial position, and B is the final position. There is a distance and displacement are equal because the ball is traveled in a straight line. Here distance is equal to displacement.